No.
Honestly, I just really wanted a grilled mac and cheese, and I'm just gonna be for real with you. This girl's not paying attention. She's gonna run into me.
It's the fact that I was actually eating this cookie in the shower.
This shit is insane. Season 4, episode 1. It's literally on repeat all the time.
Okay, you guys. The Gymshark sale is happening right now, and I am going to go shopping. They didn't restock the sizes in the browns and the colors that I wanted because I really wanted this neutral collection, but it doesn't look like I'm gonna get it. Also, I literally just woke up a couple minutes ago, and I don't have my glasses on, so y'all know I can't see. Hopefully, I'm in focus. Some of the leggings are cheaper than others, though. Like, some of these are only like 10% off. This Sherpa jacket is 40% off, though, so I'm definitely going to get that. In probably a 2X because I love them huge on me. I watched like a couple of videos and I'm really confused about which one I should get. I'm just gonna bite the bullet and get an extra large because that's like my normal sizing. And I have the XL in the sports bra too. So I'm thinking an XL in the shirt will be okay. I'm gonna get the extra large in black. If you guys are following my active account, and by active I mean like my gym account on Instagram, I have been wearing the hell out of that green camo set because it's the only set that I had from Gymshark. So I definitely want to stock up today. The purple's 37. I really love the purple though. I definitely, oh my gosh, they already sold out of the extra large in black. Okay, so we're not getting black. I need to hurry up. I think I definitely want this purple. So I'm gonna get the purple. I really want these flex, the flex set. I'll get that in gray. I'm gonna get this blue because I've been staring at her. And I actually saw, I don't want this sports bra, but I really liked the shirt that they had. Oh my gosh, and it's 50% off right now. I'm gonna snag her. Oh wow, look at this. I might have to get that. And they have this one, which looks sick. They look sickening. No! The purple sold out. The purple sold out. Okay, let me hurry up and pay for this, you guys, because people are selling my shit out. Now that I've gotten like my bulk stuff out of the way, I'm gonna go back on here and see if I want anything else. I think I basically got everything on my wish list besides these purple leggings, and I'm kind of sad about it now. Wait, are you guys seeing this? It says that it's in stock. This purple set. What's going on? If the purple set is in stock, I'm about to get it. Just for shits and giggles. I'm gonna try to check out. It says it's available. I'm gonna get another. And I have to remember, did I get that Sherpa jacket, you guys? This is the problem with online shopping. Like, literally, I just had a blackout. Okay, I'm gonna get the purple set, two bras, and that black shirt.
I am on my way. Why are you not focused on me? Me? I'm about to go to Panera Bread. Just finished shopping the Black Friday Gymshark sale. I only want to spend $500. $600 later and here we are. But I'm so happy because I have never had like aesthetic or cute gym outfits consistently. I'll have like one or two. Hence why you keep seeing that green one getting burnt out, girl, on my Instagram. And I'm planning on doing like a try on haul for my gym account. I'm really excited about my gym account, even though I'm not like the healthiest person. Like right now, I'm on my way to Panera Bread, which debatably, you know, healthy, not healthy, healthier than like, you know, McDonald's, Chick-fil-A, stuff like that. Honestly, I just really wanted a grilled mac and cheese, and I'm just gonna be for real with you. And I have come to the conclusion where it's just like, I kind of know when I'm like, okay, I've literally been eating out every single day, I need to calm down. I would eat out for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, or really breakfast and dinner because I only really eat like twice a day. That's like a whole other scenario. I don't really know if that's good or bad, but getting cute outfits for me is like so much motivation to actually work out. Long story short, I'm going to Panera Bread right now. I just finished shopping the Gymshark sale, and I keep staring at myself in the viewfinder because I have these Harry Potter ass glasses on.
You're a wizard, Harry.
I was just joking on my Instagram the other day saying that black frames just do not suit me.
Welcome to day 579 of giving sexy librarian all of the time because black frames do not suit me.
Woo. All right, y'all. I'll see you at Panera Bread.
Let's start out with the fact that I'm literally going inside of Panera Bread like this.
Can I have a grilled mac and cheese and then just a small cup of soup, the tomato soup?
All right, Just got back and just realized that I don't have any gas. I have 23 miles left until she's on empty. So I'm gonna go get some gas now. Got the goods. They ran out of tomato soup, but luckily I literally just went to Trader Joe's and got a pack of tomato soup. I don't actually drink tomato soup or eat tomato soup on the regular. I literally only eat it with the grilled mac and cheese from Panera Bread. And I forgot that I bought a tomato soup to save money, and thankfully they didn't even have it, so I had to get a refund for that. So I'm saving like $5 and some change on tomato soup today. Let me go get some gas before Miss CC starts yelling at me. And CC is my car. Yes, I did name my car. I am one of those people. This girl's not paying attention. She's gonna run into me. I named my car. Her name is Sierra. Sierra Leone is her full name, which, yes, is a place, but also is a Frank Ocean song, which is 99% of the reason why I did it. And her nickname is CC for short. And let me go fill her up before she starts yelling at me, because she do be yelling. CC, she's a spoiled gal. It's the fact that I was actually eating this cookie in the shower. It is 11:05 currently. I don't have my glasses on, so you know how that shit go. Wait, maybe I should put them on. I cannot wait to get my new frames. I hope they look better, because ever since I said Harry Potter, when I got them, like, I literally can't unsee it. This is my go-to cozy lounge around going to sleep outfit. I got this Sherpa jacket. My mom got it from Skechers, believe it or not. I need to get like 10 more of these. And I don't know if Skechers is still selling them, but if anybody knows where to get these like full Sherpa, that's inside and out, okay? I need the full effect. Let me know. I got some sweatpants. Oh, that just reminded me. I need to put lotion on my feet. I'm gonna use this Bare Vanilla lotion because I love the actual body spray. It's like my go-to body spray when I don't want to wear a perfume. So just got out the shower. I think I'm actually going to tackle, even though this is a horrible idea at 11 o'clock at night, I think I'm gonna tackle organizing my makeup, because when I moved, I didn't have all of my makeup. Finally got a chance to get all my makeup back, and also the organizer that I originally had everything in. And I think I'm gonna purge some of my stuff too, because I don't actually need all my makeup. I've done a couple of purges previously, but I'm gonna do one more. I like to do a purge every time I put stuff back in it. I'm gonna do a little makeup cleaning, and I'm also gonna do a little ear cleaning. This is actually working a little bit. If you've seen my grocery shopping video, I talked about my whole piercing situation with both ears. So far so good. I'm not noticing anything bad in my day piercing, so we shall see how that goes. I probably should not have put lotion on my hand before I started to do this, but YOLO. I need a towel. I got my little, isn't this so cute? I got a candy cane towel. I don't even know where this is from. I think it's from Home Goods. I love Home Goods. I literally go there way too much for somebody with no home, okay? All right, let me show you the damage of my makeup collection. Okay, so here's what we got going on right now. Let me turn this on so you guys can see. So right now I have just my vanity mirror. I have all of my makeup inside of here. This just houses clothes, and then I have all of this stuff on here. So these are mostly palettes, and then I have just a whole bunch of stuff in there. And then this is the makeup that I already had here. So there's literally nothing in these drawers. They're really dirty. I had to move them. I actually moved them in the pouring rain, so not a good look for the drawers. I definitely need to clean everything over here, but this is what the before is looking like. Gonna watch some BoJack. This is my favorite episode, season 4, episode 1. It's literally on repeat all the time. I haven't watched BoJack in a minute, so I decided to put him on while I tackle this.
I'm back home and I'm gonna show you what I got. Got a package from Amazon. I've been getting packs of lashes from Amazon because they're just cheaper. Foam ink, and I don't feel like getting the more expensive high-end just one pair right now, so I'm rocking with these. I went to Barnes & Noble, you guys, and I go to Barnes & Noble's all the time just to look because 9 times out of 10, the books are like half the price on Amazon, but I found this one that was not half the price on Amazon. It was a couple of dollars off, but this is a Barnes & Noble exclusive. I think this bronze cover is only at Barnes & Noble, and it was on sale for like $1 or $2 off, so I got it. It is The Psychology of Money. I actually had a subscriber, Anna, ask me for a book haul because I do remember talking about it like 6 or 7 months ago in a vlog. I was vlogging my first trip back to the gym, so that was the first time I was going back in like months. I remember in that video I was trying to be productive and I went to Target, got some books, and I also ordered some books, and she was asking me to do a book haul. 90 million books later, I have never done the book haul for her, and I have some in this unit that you guys can't see, so let me go get some for you. Oh my gosh, I literally have so many. Okay, this is nowhere near all of the ones that I actually— one of them probably just dropped. Nowhere near all of the ones that I actually ended up buying ever since I did that video. But these are the ones I have at this house, so I'll go through them really quickly with you. I have this one. Michaela Wegner convinced me to get this from her video. It's called The Power of Your Subconscious Mind. I have this one by Florence Given. The title says it all. Women Don't Owe You Pretty. I have The Magic of Thinking Big. Steve Harvey was recommending these books. How to Win and Influence People. The Power of Positive Thinking. This is also another Steve Harvey recommendation. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. I've seen a lot of people read this and talk about it, so I decided to pick it up. I got Think and Grow Rich, a classic. I think I got this idea from Graham Stephan. I love his videos. Anything he talks about financially, I listen to, so I got this book. You Are a Badass. This is just a really popular book that a lot of people read, so I decided to pick it up. Eat Smarter. Never heard anybody talking about this, but I really wanted to get into fitness and more of just conscious eating. Eating has been a struggle my entire life, so I really wanted to pick this up. And also in the back of this book, it has some recipes that you can follow, so definitely wanted to snag this in my collection. Broke Millennial. Haven't seen anybody talk about it, but I saw it at Barnes & Noble one day and really wanted to pick it up, so got this. I got 2 of the Rupi Kaur books, The Homebody and The Milk and Honey. I am a little bit through the first half of Milk and Honey, and this shit is insane. I did not think it was gonna be this deep. I thought it was like a cutesy book because of the illustrations and the covers, but no. She gets deep in these books, so I definitely need to finish Milk and Honey, and then I need to go into Homebody, but I love the poetry by Rupi Kaur. Atomic Habits is something that I was supposed to be reading a long time ago, and I never did. Guess I haven't developed any atomic habits, but I definitely need to read this. I'm a horrible reader, and I don't even know why I'm going through this book phase right now where I'm just buying everything, because I didn't even read books in school. I think the only book that I ever read fully in school was The Giver, because that was a good ass book. This is definitely the first book that I'm gonna put on my nightstand. I'm gonna do it right now. This is the one that I really, really, really wanna read. I might read this and Atomic Habits simultaneously. It's called I'm Glad My Mom Died by Jeanette McCurdy. I'm so excited to read this because I've seen so many interviews of her talking about this. Did not know she was going through all that shit when she was on iCarly. I'm really excited to read her story and her journey through her childhood and early adulthood, and I'm really excited to read this, so I'm definitely gonna put this on the nightstand as well. So that was my mini book haul for Anna, but wait, there's more, because I actually bought 2 more books while I was inside of Barnes & Noble on Amazon, because I was price checking them and I saw that they had them for literally half the price on Amazon. So the ones that I got from Amazon are the 10 times rule, which I haven't seen anybody talking about, but I was reading about it in the little inside flap of the book and it seemed really, really interesting and up my alley, so I definitely purchased that. And then I also ended up getting a book called Finding Work You Love, 3 Steps to Getting the Perfect Job After College. That is self-explanatory. Your good sis is struggling out here, and I really want to read a book about something that I'm currently going through, so I'm definitely going to pick that up. I really need to get to these books because I have so many, and I'm just such a horrible reader. Like I said, I have no idea why this like book spurt started, but now that it started, I cannot stop. I just love being surrounded by books. Just does something for the soul. I also picked this tea up. Wasn't that tea shop crazy? I have never been in a tea shop that was that elaborate before, and there were so many different options. I ended up putting it in here and adding more ice because there wasn't enough for me, but this is so good.
Lastly, I went to HomeSense. I'm surrounded by a lot of home goods, but I feel like HomeSense is like a little bit of an elevated version of home goods. And I was talking to my high school friend. We haven't talked in so long and we're on the phone. And then we got on the topic of HomeSense and I realized that I've only ever been to one. So I found one and I went inside and I did some damage. This was with all of the Christmas decorations, but these are skull ice molds. Are you joking? For Halloween, they look amazing. And you guys know how much I love dressing up, doing makeup for Halloween. I also love corny little trinkets and stuff like that for Halloween. So this was only $7 and I will be using these next year. Then I wasn't planning on getting this. Honestly, I was just looking because I wanted to see what they had in store for Christmas, but I saw this and I actually really need this. So I picked it up because I've been looking for something like this and I'm actually gonna use it right when I turn off this camera. I have jewelry just randomly placed around my room and I need to get it together. This is just like a simple little jewelry box. I'm gonna put the majority of my jewelry in there. I don't need anything elaborate. I used to have, and I think I still do have, just in storage, like a jewelry armoire that kind of stands, but I don't want anything standing. I'm like very low key right now. I don't really need a whole thing for it because I don't even have that much jewelry to begin with. So I think I'm just gonna stick with this and I'm actually gonna put it underneath of my vanity mirror. Lastly, for the big guns, I actually have a lot of silver accents in my room and all my furniture is white. But I was watching Brianna Fox and she was saying that her friend that was there shopping with her has a lot of champagne in her house and they were pointing to a lot of champagne decorations and I was like, oh my God, those are so beautiful. But I have silver in my room and I kept debating back and forth whether or not I was gonna get champagne, but I just bit the bullet and did it because I just couldn't. I kept going into stores and seeing the champagne color and I literally could not leave it there. So I got this and like, low-key, I feel like it kind of goes me trying to make it better. I'm looking at this decoration behind me that could match this. Even the trees that I currently have back there, I just feel like if this was in a different part of my room, they would look really cute. I'm really a fan of the champagne, so I got two of them. I really think this could be really versatile. It's not like extremely in your face, but it's so beautiful. That was my little impromptu, last minute, not planned Christmas shopping, Christmas decor shopping. I got those trees like a week ago at Home Goods. I might get more Christmas decor as time goes on. It's only November, what day is it? It's only November 20th. So Thanksgiving is later on this week and I still have all of December. But yeah, you guys, that is it for this vlog. I just got a notification yesterday that I am gonna be getting my Gymshark package in soon. So I'm super excited about that. Look out for that in another vlog of me opening the packages of everything. I'm super excited for my Gymshark stuff and I'm so excited to work out and feel good, confident, fresh, skinny, thick. That's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for coming along with me and I will see you in the next one. Bye.